For a U.S. governor who grew up in Omaha of the Midwestern state of Nebraska, Pete Ricketts believed the United States and China could learn from the city's legendary investor Warren Buffett, taking a long-term value investing approach to manage the most important bilateral relationship in the world. On the sidelines of the Berkshire Hathaway's annual shareholder meeting, Governor Ricketts takes Xinhua's exclusive interview on the two countries' trade and more.
Obviously, the sage of Omaha has done wonders for the investing community by really helping people think through that idea of value investing, investing for the long term.
Over the past six decades, the 86-year-old Buffett has transformed Berkshire from a struggling textile business into a financial powerhouse with insurance, energy, transportation, and manufacturing units through his famous long-term value investing strategy. His shrewd stock picks and acquisitions have contributed to steady increases in the company's earnings and earned him the nickname of the Sage of Omaha or the Oracle of Omaha.
Again, I think that's why so many Chinese investors appreciate Mr. Buffett, is because he thinks about the long term the same way the Chinese people think about long term, and the same way Nebraskans think about it as well.
Governor Ricketts has visited China twice since becoming Nebraska governor in January 2015, noting that's exactly how we should be thinking about relations between the United States and China as well.
Certainly we may have challenges short term, but we also have to remember how important the relationship between the United States and China is, and that it is for the long-term good of all the nations of the earth that we have good relationships.
As our Governor Terry Branstad, an old friend of the Chinese people and the longest-serving governor in the United States, has been tapped to be the next U.S. ambassador to China, Ricketts believed is also a very positive sign that shows Trump's commitment to the relationship with China.
But that's what we have to do, is continue to have that dialogue about what are the things that are important for the United States, what are the things that are important for China, how can we find that common ground to be able to expand the relationship so that we can continue, both countries can continue to see the prosperity that's been created by our trade relationships. You know, everybody really needs to understand is that it's a mutually beneficial relationship, that when we're exchanging goods and services between countries, we are doing that because it's helping both countries, and then it also helps build those ties that creates that stability around the world.